Hi everyone. Have you ever wondered, when beetle moves along the sand, within tens of hundreds of centimeter, scorpion lying nearby, without actually seeing or hearing it, turns towards it and dashes onto it? How can it locate its prey so precisely? Well, today's topic is waves. We are going to understand how nature transfers information from one place to the other with the use of as simple a phenomena as wave. Wave is actually this, the transmission of information in the form of energy from one place to the other. If we say about waves, automatically the other thing comes to our mind. What is a particle and what is the difference between a particle and a wave? Particle is a tiny concentration of matter capable of transmitting energy, whereas wave, on the other hand, is exactly the opposite. It's broadband distribution of energy filling the entire space through which it passes. Okay, why to study waves? Okay, waves are everywhere. I'm talking to you. I'm creating wave in air, compression, rarefaction, coming from me, going towards your ear. There is a transfer of energy. A musical concert, the melody, it's all about the performer creating the waves, the listener receiving the waves. Or the structural wave vibrational analysis. For example, the failure of the Tacoma Narrows Bridge. As simple a thing as wind induced vibration in the structure, and the whole gigantic structure failed like cards. It was a catastrophic failure. So the study of waves becomes very important from all these points of view. To classify waves, waves are of, broadly classifying, they are of three categories. Mechanical waves, electromagnetic waves, matter waves. Mechanical waves follows Newton's laws of motion. They exist within material mediums. Examples are like water waves, sound waves that we are producing, likewise music that we hear. Second category is electromagnetic waves. Electromagnetic wave is the electric and magnetic pulses traveling through space, because they can exist in vacuum also. So it is the changing nature of the electric and magnetic field that travels through the space which creates the electromagnetic wave, and they can exist in vacuum also. They don't require material media for their propagation. Example is light, radar, x-rays, gamma rays, etc. Matter wave, third kind of wave, actually De Broglie postulated that even particles behave like waves. So subatomic particles like electrons, protons, etc., they also behave like wave, and their equation is wave motion is governed by the Schrodinger wave equation. So that is not the topic of our discussion today. So, but broadly classifying, these are the three categories. Although we are going to mostly deal with mechanical waves, but the study of other waves are analogous. So in case of mechanical waves, there are particles involved. There will be particle motion in some direction, and the wave as a whole will travel in some other direction. So we will be talking about two things, particle motion and wave motion. Just mind it, in case of electromagnetic wave, there are no particles involved. It is the electric and magnetic fields which are moving, which are periodically changing. So there is the change in the electric and magnetic field, and wave travels in some direction. So when I'm telling particle, just keep in mind, in case of electromagnetic wave, it is about the electric and magnetic field. In case of mechanical wave, it is about the particles themselves. So I'm using particle as that terminology. So based on this kind of nature of the particle motion, so in case of electromagnetic wave, the nature of the way electric and magnetic field is changing. Based on that, we can classify waves into two broad categories. One is called as longitudinal wave. In longitudinal wave, the particle motion is along the direction of the wave travel. So, for example, take this case. I have something for you. So, let's suppose each circle, this ring, as a particle. So, if I give some velocity, small velocity at this end to the particle, like this, you can visualize as the energy of this particle, this I'm giving a small compression at this end, how it is traveling up that small compression, right? So the energy is traveling in this direction, and this is compressing it. As a result, the nearby particles are getting compressed, and in such a way, compression and rarefaction, the energy is traveling from one end to the other end. You can see from top something looks like moving. In case of the transverse wave, the particles move perpendicular to the direction of the wave travel. So in this case, you can see I have made it like this, so that the these are, suppose these strips, they are particles, so they can move only perpendicular to this direction. I have held them, so they cannot move up and down like this. They are only allowed to move like this. All right, so just visualize it. Suppose I give velocity in this direction. Let's see how this energy is traveling. So let me give some more energy. It will be easy to visualize. Suppose I give like this. See, I'm giving energy to this particle alone, but you can see some pattern traveling. So this particle is moving like this, up and down, but this is a direction, this direction is perpendicular to this direction where the pattern is traveling. This information is traveling along this direction. This is small motion, how it is traveling. Just small, I'm giving here only the motion. It is traveling. Alright, so this is called transverse wave. So as we have seen, there are two categories of wave as per the particle motion. One is called longitudinal, the other is transverse. So to give some example, the pressure wave in air, sound waves, they are the examples of longitudinal wave. And for transverse wave, although sound waves come also in the form of transverse wave in solids, but the very good example of transverse wave is electromagnetic wave, light wave. In this case, the particle is traveling in one direction, and perpendicular to the direction of the particle, remember, particle means in this case electric and magnetic field, both they are perpendicular to each other as well as perpendicular to the direction of the wave travel. So these are the examples of the two waves. Now in both these waves, longitudinal wave and transverse waves, are called as traveling waves. We will see later, wave is not as simple as this. There are many things involved, and moreover, waves interact with each other. There are superpositions, there are many things. So there can be some standing waves happening, which are as if standing, not traveling. But these are the cases of traveling waves. So let's get back to our first question that we discussed, scorpion. How can it precisely locate its prey? Okay, let's come back to it. You know the scorpion is nocturnal. It can't see or hear. But what it does is, it sends out two waves, one longitudinal, another one transverse. Now, transverse, I give example, light as a transverse wave. It travels extremely fast, 3 lakhs kilometer per second. Longitudinal wave, sound, does not travel as fast as that, because it has limitations with the materials in which it's traveling, and it exists within materials only. But the sound wave can also be of transverse nature and longitudinal nature, depending on the material it is traveling. In solids, it can have both the types. But in that case, the transverse wave is slower compared to the longitudinal one. So a slight movement of the prey on sand creates these two waves, longitudinal and transverse. both travels with different velocities.
As we discussed, the longitudinal wave travels with 150 meter per second around, and the transverse wave travels with 50 meter per second approx. Now, every living being has the sense of passage of time. So what happens if the prey is located at this distance and the two waves, one longitudinal, so in case of longitudinal wave, particle motion is along the direction of the wave travel like this, right? And another transverse, particle motion is kind of like this, up and down, but wave is traveling in this direction. Alright? Reaches the scorpion. And the two waves, both of the waves reaches, but they have some time gap. It can sense that time gap. Say it is delta t. What is time? Time is distance by velocity. So this delta t will be that distance d transverse. Minus d by v longitudinal. So this is delta t. So as every living being has the sense of passage of time, the scorpion can sense this delta t. The v inherently it knows. It knows that what is the velocity of sound, longitudinal and transverse along a solid. So with that it can sense t, the distance of the prey. See how wonderful the nature is. How scorpion is using maths to get its fulfill its daily needs, like something to eat. Okay, now let's understand wave more mathematically. We all have studied about sine and cosine functions. They are a wonderful example of wave. So we can begin from there. Actually, a very popular term is there called sine wave or the cosine wave. They are the very fundamental waves. Every other wave can be formed out of them. So let's begin with a sine wave. So we have seen in case of the transverse wave as well as in the case of the longitudinal wave that there was a particle motion in one direction.